الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ربي اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما ربي زدني علما آمين يا رب العالمين أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Welcome to a yet another exciting course from Team CIFIA. This course content has been created under the guidance of Sheikh Mir Asadullah Quadri, and I am a member of Team CIFIA, going to be your trainer today. Together, you and I will go into this exciting journey of learning about this important concept of Sahih Iman. So, welcome aboard. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Quadri, rahmatullah alayhi. This course content is divided into the following lectures. Introduction. Hadhrat Momin Ali Quadri rahmatullah alayh is my father, mentor, and the first teacher who taught me the alphabets. He taught me Arabic, English, Urdu, Quran, Ahadith, logic, Islamic fiqh, and tasawwuf. During my secondary school days, Sheikh used to give me a passage in Urdu daily and asked me to translate it in English and Arabic. I was required to read that translation loudly in front of the whole family the next day. Then he used to correct it. This is how I learned and achieved mastery in Urdu, English, and to some extent in Arabic. He used to teach mathematics, physics, chemistry, English, and other subjects as well on a regular basis. This was the reason I was top in my class throughout my school studies. He used to encourage us to write poetry and memorize Urdu kalam in praise of dignitaries of Islam. Sheikh also guided me to develop the right etiquette and virtuous characters in life. In addition, he taught me wrestling and encouraged me to join gym for regular exercise. He imbibed in me the desire to do something good in life so that people remember long after we are gone from this world. I have never seen a Sheikh like Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh, who has done so much zikr-e-ilahi. I do not know how many million times he has recited Asma-e-ilahiyah because he never disclosed this to us. He used to sit like we sit in Qaida, in Salah, from Salatul Zuhr till beyond Salatul Isha, getting up only for Salatul Asr, Maghrib and Isha. After Isha, his Murideen used to visit him. When we used to get up for Salatul Fajr, we used to find him on the musalla doing zikr after his tahajjud prayers. He did that for decades. He also taught me zikr, which I continued for the rest of my life. He was instrumental in developing in me the love of Allah, his apostle Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, sahaba and awliya Allah. Hadhrat Hussain Shajauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh, the son and successor of Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh, once told me that he was 10 years older than my father, but he and my father were very good friends. As my father was murid and khalifa of Hadhrat Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh. Hadhrat Pia Qadri rahmatullah alayh, one of the close murideen of Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh, was also a great friend of my father. He used to visit us regularly long after the death of our father and had become like a member of our family. He used to tell us a lot about the life of Hadhrat Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh. His mazar is located attached to a mosque in Nampally area in Hyderabad, India. My mother, Sayyida Begum rahmatullah alayh, played a great role in our religious upbringing and character building. She used to tell us stories of the prophets and the dignitaries of Islam. I remember we used to cry a lot in Muharram when my mother used to tell us about Imam Hussain radiyallahu ta'ala anhu and the episode of Karbala. During school holidays, she used to tell us about Ghausul Azam radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Khwaja Gharib Nawaz radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, and other awliya Allah. Once in my early childhood, she told me that tea drinking was bad. So, I did not touch the tea for the following 20 years till I was employed. Thanks to my parents, it is because of them that I was saved from any type of bad habits in life.
This course provides a brief account of the life of Sheikh Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Sheikh Mir Asadullah Qadri. Sheikh's ancestors.
Sheikh Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh is Sayyid Al-Hasani Wal-Husayni. It is reported that his ancestors migrated from Arabia to India when Khilji dynasty was ruling India. Later, they shifted to Dakhan and settled at a place called Petanchu. Sheikh's father. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh's grandfather, Mir Rustam Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh, lived in Patancheru. He was well-known sheikh in that town. People used to flock to him for dua. His son, Hadhrat Mir Faizullah Qadri rahmatullah alayh, father of Sheikh Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh, was employed in the police department in the old state of Hyderabad. He was posted at Hyderabad in 1915. This was the reason for Hadhrat Faizullah Qadri rahmatullah alayh to shift his family to Hyderabad in that year. Hadhrat Faizullah Qadri rahmatullah alayh was a Sufi at heart. He was fond of Hadhrat Mir Momin rahmatullah alayh, whose dargah is located at a hilltop in Hyderabad. It is here that he prayed Allah for a pious son. His supplication was answered and a son was born in 1919. He named the son Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Blessed birth. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh was born on Friday, May 2nd, 1919, corresponding to Shaban 1st, 1337 AH. Education. Hadhrat Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh was taught Arabic, Quran, Hadith by his father Hadhrat Mir Faizullah Qadri. Later, he joined a madrasa where both religious and worldly education was imparted. His entire education was done in the state of Hyderabad. After completing high school, he joined a college affiliated to Usmania University and completed BA. Later, he completed bachelor's degree in Unani medicine. Baya, Ijaza and Khilafa. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh took Baya on the hand of Sheikh Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqi rahmatullah alayh at the age of 21 years. It is reported that he had undergone rigorous religious training on the hands of Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqi rahmatullah alayh. He used to sit alone inside a mountain cave at Banjara Hills in Hyderabad and used to do zikr-e-jahir for hours every night. Those days, Banjara Hills was a mountain covered with thick forest and wildlife. After some time, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Siddiqi rahmatullah alayh asked him to perform Salatul Asr at a mosque close by the dargah of Sayyid Ahmad Badepa rahmatullah alayh at Ahmad Nagar area in congregation. Then go to Pahari Sharif area 25 to 30 kilometers away and perform Salatul Maghrib at a mosque close by the dargah of Hadhrat Baba Sharfuddin Sohorwardi rahmatullah alayh, which was located at a hilltop. The only way to reach that mosque was to climb the hilltop through 200 rough stone stairs. Sheikh used to perform Asr at Ahmadnagar Mosque and rush on his cycle to Pahari Sharif to perform Maghrib prayers, and he did that for over a year. It is reported that once Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqi rahmatullah alayh asked him to lead Salatul Fajr at the Pahari Sharif Mosque for 1 month. Sheikh was confused as he knew that there is an Imam working at Pahari Sharif Mosque. However, as per the instruction of his Sheikh, Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh went for Salatul Fajr a little earlier and sat in the mosque and was thinking how to lead the prayers in the presence of the appointed people in that mosque. When the time for congregation arrived, it was announced that the regular Imam was sick and he could not make it for the Salatul Fajr. People looked for a suitable Imam. They spotted Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh sitting in a corner of the mosque and requested him to lead the prayers. The regular Imam could not make it for Salah for the following 1 month, and Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh became the Imam for Salatul Fajr in that mosque for 1 month. After years of rigorous training, Sheikh Abdul Qadir Siddiqi rahmatullah alayh gave him Khilafah. Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh also had the opportunity to learn the Tasawwuf under the able guidance of Hadhrat Badruddin Khalid Wajudi Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Hadhrat Khalid Wajudi rahmatullah alayh also gave him khilafah. Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh spent a few years in the company of Hadhrat Azizullah Shah Irfani rahmatullah alayh, who was successor and Jai Nashin of Hadhrat Ilahi Bakhsh rahmatullah alayh, the Arabic and Hadith teacher of Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh at Darul Uloom, Hyderabad. Government service. After completing graduation, Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh joined government service. However, he left the job after a few years and concentrated full-time on religious education of people. Spiritual eminence. Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh was famous for tawakkal and charity. He never kept anything for himself or for his family. There were no regular sources of income after he left the job. For years, the house was run on a meager income of some Arabic teaching. Even the meager income was often given in charity. Many a times, there was no food at home for his kids. The children used to have only one pair of kurta and pajama for the whole year that was made on the occasion of Eid al-Fitr by some relatives. Sheikh used to sit every day doing zikr from Zuhr till Isha, sitting straight in the direction of Qibla, taking breaks only for Asr and Maghrib prayers. He used to conduct classes for Quran understanding regularly, in which Tafsir Siddiqui was taught. Many people used to attend these classes. Every day after Isha, scores of people used to visit the Sheikh for regular education and for their problems. Most of them used to be his murideen. Sheikh used to give bayah in Quadri and Chishti orders. People who were close to the Sheikh testified that he was a prominent member of spiritual hierarchy of great awliya Allah of his time.
All right, this concludes the lecture. Take a breather and we will get back in a minute to continue this journey of learning.
Hadhrat Hussain Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh. Hadhrat Hussain Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh, the son and successor of Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh and Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh, were close friends. It is reported that Hadhrat Shujauddin Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh was 10 years older than Sheikh Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Hadhrat Sharfuddin Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Hadhrat Sharfuddin Qadri rahmatullah alayh, popularly known as Pia Qadri 1910 to 1985, was one of the close murideen of Hadhrat Abdul Qadir Siddiqui rahmatullah alayh. He was a close friend of Sheikh Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh and a regular visitor of the Sheikh. Even after the death of Hadhrat Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh in 1972, he maintained the close relations until his death in 1985. He and his wife often visited Sheikh's residence. Hadhrat Sharfuddin Qadri rahmatullah alayh died on May 14, 1985, 23 Shaban, 1405 AH. His mazar is located at Nampally area in Hyderabad, India. Spiritual chain. There are two spiritual chains of the Sheikh, one in Qadri Qadiri Silsila and the other in Qadri Khalidi Silsila. Spiritual chain 1. First, Sultan al-Anbiya wal-Mursaleen, Rahmatul al-Alameen, Shafi'ul Mudnibin, Ahmad Mujtaba, Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Second, Imam al-Masharikh wal-Maghareb, Asadullah al-Ghalib, Amir al-Mu'mineen, Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Third, Amir al-Mu'mineen Sayyid al-Shahada Hadhrat Imam Hussain alayhi salam. Fourth, Imam al-Abidin Amir al-Mu'mineen Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Fifth, Imam al-Muttaqin Amir al-Mu'mineen Muhammad al-Bakhar alayhi salam. Sixth, Imam al-Sadiqin Amir al-Mu'mineen Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salam. Seventh, Imam al-Kamilin Amir al-Mu'mineen Musa Kazim alayhi salam. Eighth, Imam al-Wasilin Amir al-Mu'mineen Musa Rada alayhi salam. Ninth, Hadhrat Sheikh ad-Din Maruf Kirki radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Tenth, Hadhrat Diya ad-Din Siri Sakhati radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 11th, Hadhrat Junaid Baghdadi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 12th, Shayat Abdullah Abu Bakr Shibli radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 13th, Hadhrat Abu Al-Fadl Abd Al-Wahid Tamimi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 14th, Hadhrat Alauddin Abu Al-Fara Tartusi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 15th, Hadhrat Abu Al-Hasan Ali Al-Hankari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 16th, Hadhrat Abu Sayyid Mubarak Al-Makhrami radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 17th, Qutub Al-Arifin Murshid Al-Salikin Sayyid Abd Al-Qadir Jilani Mehbub Subhani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 18th, Hadhrat Abdullah rahmatullah alayhi. 19th, Hadhrat Abdullah ibn Yusuf Asadi rahmatullah alayhi. 20th, Hadhrat Muhammad Ahmad rahmatullah alayhi. 21st, Hadhrat Abu Ahmad Muhammad rahmatullah alayhi. 22nd, Hadhrat Fakhruddin rahmatullah alayhi. 23rd, Hadhrat Mohiuddin Ahmad rahmatullah alayhi. 24th, Hadhrat Abu Bakr rahmatullah alayhi. 25th, Hadhrat Sharfuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 26th, Hadhrat Muhammad Mirza rahmatullah alayhi. 27th, Hadhrat Ismail rahmatullah alayhi. 28th, Hadhrat Abu Bakr Salam rahmatullah alayhi. 29th, Hadhrat Ahmad ibn Musa rahmatullah alayhi. 30th, Hadhrat Junaid Yamani rahmatullah alayhi. 31st, Hadhrat Abdul Qadir rahmatullah alayhi. 32nd, Hadhrat Sirajuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 33rd, Hadhrat Aminuddin rahmatullah alayhi. 34th, Hadhrat Muhammad ibn Yunus rahmatullah alayhi. 35th, Hadhrat Safiyuddin Ahmad Khashashi rahmatullah alayhi. 36th, Hadhrat Abdullah ibn Ahmad Bafakhi rahmatullah alayhi. 37th, Hadhrat Sayyid Abdullah ibn Ahmad Barum rahmatullah alayhi. 38th, Hadhrat Sayyid Ulawi Barum rahmatullah alayhi. 39th, Hadhrat Khwaja rahmatullah rahmatullah alayhi. 40th, Hadhrat Muhammad Shah Muhammad Rafiuddin Khandahari rahmatullah alayhi. 41st, Hadhrat Mir Shajauddin Hussain rahmatullah alayhi. 42nd, Hadhrat Sayyid Muhammad Badshah Husseini rahmatullah alayhi. 43rd, Hadhrat Khaja Sayyid Muhammad Siddiq Ali Husseini Mahbuballah rahmatullah alayhi. 44th, Hadhrat Muhammad Abdul Qadir Siddiqi Qadri Hasrat rahmatullah alayhi. 45th, Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayhi. Spiritual chain 2. First, Sultanul Anbiya wal Mursaleen Rahmatul Alameen Shafi'ul Mudnibin Ahmad Mushtaba Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Second, Imam al-Masharikh wal-Maghrib Asadullah al-Ghalib Amir al-Mu'mineen Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salam. Third, Amir al-Mu'mineen Sayyid al-Shahada Hadhrat Imam Hussain alayhi salam. Fourth, Imam al-Abidin Amir al-Mu'mineen Zain al-Abidin alayhi salam. Fifth, Imam al-Muttaqin Amir al-Mu'mineen Muhammad al-Bakr alayhi salam. Sixth, Imam al-Sadiqin Amir al-Mu'mineen Jafar al-Sadiq alayhi salam. 7th, Imam al-Kamilin Amir al-Mu'mineen Musa Kazim alayhi salam. 8th, Imam al-Wasilin Amir al-Mu'mineen Musa Rada alayhi salam. 9th, Hadhrat Sheikh ad-Din Maruf Kirki radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 10th, Hadhrat Diya ad-Din Siri Sakati radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 11th, Hadhrat Junaid Baghdadi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 12th, Shayat Abdullah Abu Bakr Shibli radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 13th, Hadhrat Abu Al-Fadl Abd Al-Wahid Tamimi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 14th, Hadhrat Alauddin Abu Al-Fara Tartusi radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 15th, Hadhrat Abu Al-Hasan Ali Al-Khuraishi Al-Hankari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 16th, Hadhrat Abu Sayyid Mubarak Al-Makhrami radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 17th, Qutub Al-Arifin Murshid Al-Salikin Sayyid Abd Al-Qadir Jilani Mehbub Subhani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. 18th, Hadhrat Abd Al-Aziz rahmatullah alayhi. 19th, Hadhrat Sayyid Muhammad Hataq rahmatullah alayhi. 20th, Hadhrat Sayyid Shams ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 21st, Hadhrat Sayyid Sharaf ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 22nd, Hadhrat Sayyid Zain ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 23rd, Hadhrat Sayyid Wali ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 24th, Hadhrat Sayyid Noor ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 25th, Hadhrat Sayyid Yahya rahmatullah alayh. 26th, Hadhrat Abi Bakr rahmatullah alayh. 27th, Hadhrat Sayyid Husam ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 28th, Hadhrat Sayyid Muhammad Darwish rahmatullah alayh. 29th, Hadhrat Sayyid Noor ad-Din rahmatullah alayh. 30th, Hadhrat Sayyid Abd al-Wahhab rahmatullah alayh. 31st, Hadhrat Sayyid Ismail rahmatullah alayh. 32nd, Hadhrat Sayyid Abi Bakr al-Thani rahmatullah alayh. 33rd, Hadhrat Sayyid Abd al-Qadir al-Thani rahmatullah alayh. 34th, Hadhrat Sayyid Ali rahmatullah alayh. 35th, Hadhrat Sayyid Mustafa rahmatullah alayh. 36th, Hadhrat Sayyid Abdullah Shah Sahib rahmatullah alayh. 37th, Hadhrat Ejaz Nawaz Mehboob e Rehmani Shamsuddin Muhammad Chishti al-Qadri rahmatullah alayh. 38th, Hadhrat Bekas Nawaz Khwaja Shah Abu Rada Sayyid Muhammad Badshah Muhyiddin Wajudi al-Qadri rahmatullah alayh. 39th, Hadhrat Khwaja Abu al-Fayed Shah Muhammad Khalid Wajudi al-Qadri rahmatullah alayh. 40th, Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh. Death. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh died on June 24, 1972, corresponding to 12th Jumada 1, 1392 AH, and was buried near the mazar of Hadhrat Sayyid Ahmad Badepa rahmatullah alayh in Ahmednagar, Hyderabad, India. The picture here shows the mazarat of Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh and Amma Jan Sayyida Begum rahmatullah alayh, Zawj-e Muhtarama of Hadhrat Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh and blessed mother of Sheikh Mir Asadullah Qadri. Hadhrat Mir Momin Ali Qadri rahmatullah alayh's dargah is located nearby the dargah of Hadhrat Sayyid Ahmad Badepa rahmatullah alayh in Ahmednagar, Hyderabad. His urs is celebrated on 12 Jumada 1 every lunar calendar. Hadhrat Momin rahmatullah alayh had a special love for Sayyid Ahmad Badepa rahmatullah alayh, Khalifa of Hadhrat Nizamuddin Awliya rahmatullah alayh, whose mazar is located at Ahmednagar area in Hyderabad. There was a great spiritual bond between the two shuyukh.
Alright, this concludes the lecture. Before you go, you can find more information of many other Islamic topics like the one we discussed in this course at sahihiman.com/books. Hundreds of books available explaining multiple Islamic topics up for grabs for free. So do check it out. Thank you for signing up for this course. We hope you had a great time learning about this important topic as we had preparing this course for you. See you again for another exciting learning experience at the correct Islamic Faith International Academy. Until then, it's goodbye from us at Team CIFIA.